Hi, everyone. Hi, everyone. Thank you so much for joining me today. I know this is the pretty much the last talk of a day, so I was thinking about it and I decided to make it short, very light and general, and hopefully funny. This is my CTO and co-founder, Marcin. He strongly advised me against trying to be funny, because generally this is a face he makes when I make a joke. So please, even if you don't find my jokes funny, please just pretend that you're laughing so I can prove him wrong. It's kind of a personal thing, you know? So please do. So, given the topic of the conversation, I would imagine that some of you, or at least all of you or some of you have dreams or nightmares about automation and automating your mobile app development. So I'm delighted to share with you what I've learned as a CEO of NativeTap. And just give you a little bit of a context as to why I know one thing or two about that topic is because NativeTap is a device farm. It's a very unique device farm. We have over 50 different devices that you can have in your, any of them you can have in your hand in less than 10 seconds. So I know what you're thinking. Is it teleportation? Well, we tried that and it didn't work, so we tried a different approach. So NativeTap is basically the way it works. You download our app on your Android device, and you choose the device you want to interact with. Those are devices that we have in a data center. And basically, within less than 10 seconds, the device, your device becomes the controller of the device in the data center, and you can interact with it remotely using touch, so you can test your apps. We built our own ADB, so you can not only test in real time, but you can also debug in real time. So over the time when we were building NativeTap, I spoke to hundreds and hundreds of people within the mobile Android community, developers, testers, product managers, and they shared two things I've learned. One, they wanted to automate everything. Second thing is that they loved funny GIFs and memes. So I decided to combine the two things and use mainly GIFs and memes in order to visually support the points I'm making. So how does the dream of automation is born? It normally starts with a nightmare, and it's this guy. So basically, somebody comes to you and says, I want 7 features, the deadline is last week, and I want it to work very well on every single device. So obviously, you don't have time to write tests, you just develop the features, and then the release comes, and pre-release, you decide to, you need to test your mobile application, but you don't have device, you don't have enough testers, so you decide, we can do it ourselves. So you realize that, you know, you have a pair of hands, you have an Android device, your colleague has an Android device and a pair of hands, maybe Joe in accounts has a device and a pair of hands, plumber that was helping you with some work in the office also has a pair of hands and device. So you decide that your company is self-sufficient, independent, resourceful, and device-full place. And then you can test it within the company. So that quickly turns out not to be such a great idea. Joe, that is, might be good with accounts, he's probably not so good with testing mobile applications, and by the time he realizes that there is a bug, he forgets how he actually got to that point. Your CTO becomes quieter and quieter and types the keyboard faster and louder, and you quickly understand why do they call it the war room testing. Because after it's done, there is a silence and not a good one. So this guy shows up again and says, look, this is not how it's possible and this is not how it's going to work. You can't have the whole company doing testing when, you know, when we, before every release. So you say, okay, we can, then you basically come up with an idea, you can hire someone to do it for you. So you realize there are thousands of people that can do it for you, and you can outsource it, or you can do crowd testing. But then you realize that you just spent, you know, they did a great job, you spent a lot of money, they've discovered the bugs, but you realize that you don't have resources to fix all of those bugs. So basically you paid a lot of money for telling somebody to tell you that your app is buggy, which you probably already knew. So who comes again? This guy, right? And he tells you finally, you know what? This is ridiculous that we're paying so much money for manual testing. You are an engineer. You should be able to write a code that makes the machine do it. And then you basically say, finally. Finally, the dream of automation is happening. You're thinking, oh my gosh, am I in heaven? Or is that wonderful? So you start writing and automating your tests. But then you realize quite quickly that is actually a lot of work. And you can't automate everything, right? So you write a test for things that you automate, but then you realize you need the devices, right? And you don't have the devices. And maybe you're using at that point one of the device farms and you run your tests across different devices, but then you realize that the bug reports come and then you have to debug it without having a device. Nobody asks a developer to debug software without a computer anymore. But somehow, in mobile app development, that's completely acceptable. So you basically try to debug it without the device, and you run the, you know, send it again to the cloud and test, and the loop is very long. You're getting frustrated. Maybe you fix it, or maybe you're not fixing. And then you quickly realize that actually some manual testing is needed. And yeah, so at some point on the mobile app development, you will need the manual testing. And you're really realizing that your dream of automation is actually in itself a nightmare, because it is like it's not possible to automate everything. So what is my point? Well, my point is exactly that. You know, you should automate everything, but you shouldn't think that this is going to be a solution to all of your quality software problems. Tests are great for certain things, but they basically are just task automation. And tests cannot adapt, they cannot creatively solve the problems. So at least for now, maybe with you know, artificial intelligence, you know, that will be possible in the near future. But so far, you should accept that you are a human, and you know, in the human and mobile app development needs humans and needs human touch. So that really is my conclusion. And if this guy shows up in the office and tells you otherwise, please give him my email. And I will talk to him and explain that that's simply not how it works. Thank you.